When I was growing up in the South, my parents must have looked like an odd couple to most folks. As a kid, you don't notice the dried snot on your lip, much less the fact that your father has blue eyes and blonde hair, while your mother has brown, almond-shaped eyes and black, oops, I meant auburn chestnut hair. Sorry, Mom. That's not to say, however, that I didn't realize that we were a little different than other folks around us.
You keep saying you got something for me, something you call love, but confess, you've been a messin' where you shouldn't have been a messin', and now someone else is getting all your best. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you.
This is ridiculous.
Bobby, why do you always have to start?
Because this is ridiculous. You know, I have to be able to wear shoes in the car. It's against the law to drive without shoes.
Bobby.
What happens if we get pulled over for speeding or something?
Yubba.
You want me to get two tickets?
Bobby, you ever going to shut up? Michael, you stand still.
It just doesn't make sense. People need to wear shoes in the car.
Bobby, you talk too much, your mouth is going to hurt.
Every time we got out of the car, it was the same thing. My father didn't realize that his moaning about having to take off his shoes in the car attracted way more attention than if he would have just taken his humiliation quietly. It was ritualistic, but it never made sense to me. But then again, neither did the terms hamburger or hot dog. They didn't need to make sense because they were inherently American. Just like my father. Just like Little League Baseball.
Okay, Dad, I'm ready.
What's the matter with your stirrups?
What do you mean?
Why are they so long? Did the coach ask what size you were?
No.
Jiminy Christmas. Those things would be long for me. Take them off. Let me have a look at them.
You would think that as an American, my father would have developed a passion for baseball, like most young boys. But I think growing up in a house with five older sisters, my dad had a slightly different experience than most boys. And I suppose the rigors of farm life left him even less free time for other activities. See, even though my father was as American as apple pie, he apparently didn't eat a whole lot of it. It may sound a little strange, but a lot of those things that made us different from other folks in the neighborhood had to do with our feet.
Before you came in the house?
My mother always told me that we did things a certain way because it was Korean custom. Of course, I always retorted by saying that we weren't living in Korea anymore. That comment usually earned me a good rap across the face. It seemed like as I got older, the customs became more and more bizarre. I knew that a lot of the things we did related to my mother's compulsive sense of cleanliness. This made sense considering she spent many years cleaning other people's houses when she first immigrated to the U.S. But she had this one habit, no, obsession, that baffled Dad and I both. She would vacuum the house shortly after noon. That made sense. We had been up and around during the morning and we could have spilled or dropped something on the floor. Then she would vacuum again just before we went to bed. I guess one could argue that during the early evening, people were moving about the house and may have been less than immaculate, I guess. A lot of people wake up to an alarm clock, a whistling tea kettle, even roosters. In my house, it was the sound of that old Hoover sucking up all the dirt and filth that the grubby little elves must have left after their nightly convention in our living room. What was she thinking? No one had set foot on the carpet between the hours of 10 p.m. and 5 a.m. At that point, she must have been sucking up atomic dust. I remember the first time I read Macbeth. When Lady Macbeth shouts, "Out, damned spot, out, I say," I would imagine my mother trying to vacuum out a kimchi stain. Actually, having a reputation of being that clean had its advantages. At a very young age, I read that one of the first three things a woman almost unconsciously looks at in a man is the condition of his shoes. Funny, I can't even remember what the other two things are. It took me an entire childhood to figure it out, but it finally made sense. What mattered more than looking different or speaking a different language were the weird things I did. The things I did because of my mother, not Korean customs. But I guess that's what makes families. All those things that we did together. Every silly little idea or habit that we practiced. It wasn't the fact that we all had the same last name or that we even lived in the same house. No, I'm convinced that what makes a family, what really makes a family, is doing things together that you are too embarrassed to do or talk about in public.